Hello, Philippa.
Hello.
And just want to ask you a little bit about how you think Big Church Day Out's going.
It's going amazing. We've never, ever had this weather as long as I've been coming to Big Church Day Out.
So
it's a real blessing to have the sunshine and not people to be sinking in their tents.
Yeah, it's lovely. And we heard you this morning. You sounded wonderful, or this afternoon. It was absolutely fantastic.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, good. And what did you think the kind of crowd reception was?
It was really good. I just feel like because I've come from the ground up here and played all the tiny venues, and I think I'm just kind of the homegrown. I feel like they sort of, I belong to them really.
Yeah, that's great.
Those lovely people. So
that's great. And we're here from Christians Against Poverty, so I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about that. I know that you know a little bit about CAP already, and I also know that in your kind of story prior to being a Christian, you're in debt yourself. And so I just wanted to ask you a little bit about that. Kind of, how did it feel for you being in debt? What were the thoughts that kind of that brought up? How did you feel in that situation?
Well, I was in debt from the age of sort of being able to get a store card. And the thing is, it's just so easily done. It just so easy to spend the money, and then it takes so long to pay it back. And for me, being in debt was a big part of the darkness that led me towards asking God for help, because it's hard to really pinpoint how dark it is. You just feel like there's vultures at the door all the time. People are always ringing you.
Yeah.
You're always getting these red letters through. And it's just, if you don't know what to do with it, the easy thing to do, which is the wrong thing, but the thing we do, is just to sort of stick your head in the sand. And that's what I did. And fortunately, after I became a Christian, I spoke to my mum about it, and she helped me. And I paid her, she paid, got a loan, paid it off, and I paid her back, which is, you know, how I got around it. But I can certainly identify with how difficult it is to be in debt.
Which, and yeah, I mean, fantastic that your mum could help you in that situation.
Yeah.
And we all know that there are so many people out there that don't have that help. And that is what Christians Against Poverty is there for. What do you think about the work that CAP does? What do you think about kind of working in partnership with local churches to help people that were in your situation?
I think because we're in this part of the world, and there are so many other types of poverty, and you sort of see them, and they're a lot more easy to identify, but this particular type of poverty is so extreme because of what it does to people's lives, and what it does to their spirits, and what it does to their families. And I think it's so amazing that there are organizations you can go to like CAP that can intervene, and the fact that it's a Christian organisation is extra good, because I know that for other people that I know who've been in debt, who've gone to similar organisations which aren't Christian, and have even gotten into trouble in those situations because they haven't been what they've said they would be, or they've charged them loads of money for the service. And I think CAP is extra special really, because it's just like, it's just grace. It's grace. I mean, I think one of the worst things about being in debt is sometimes, like in my case, it was totally self-inflicted. Like, I mean, I know other people lose their jobs and it's not, but for me, it just was bad choices. So I felt like I didn't deserve any help. And I'm sure a lot of people come to CAP feeling that way. But, you know, God is a God of second chances.
Absolutely.
And everybody deserves a good life. You know, everybody deserves to feel not terrified when they wake up, and to be able to eat properly and provide for their families. So it's a really valuable thing that CAP does.
Absolutely, we would echo all of those things and all of those feelings that people do have. And you're right, you know, that kind of grace thing is a massive thing for us, because who deserves what we have from God? And that is awesome. So I also wanted to ask you a little bit about, you've obviously got a heart for people, obviously got a heart for kind of going beyond what you're called to do in terms of your singing, and you've just set up your charity. And I just wanted to talk about, what do you think, you know, kind of the role is in worship, in singing, in moving people from that place of just going to church on a Sunday to actually doing more than that, like through CAP or through, you know, kind of other things?
I really believe that we're called really to mission, because if we weren't, then we would just be sucked up into heaven when we got saved. But we're here for a reason.
It's good.
And I think that if you've got profile of any sort, it's really good to be able to use that for good. And and we all have profile. We have profile in our family, in our workplace, and for sort of someone like me, it's more obvious because we've got stages and stuff we can sing on. But I think it's really important to use your influence for God, really.
Right. Well, thanks, Philippa. And yeah, thank you for letting us speak to you today. And thank you for sharing what you've shared. You know, it really is valuable for us to know what you feel and how you felt and how CAP can help people.